So if anybody from the game comes in here, they won't be able to sneaky sneak and, get a little peek at what's going on. All right, so we're in. Everybody can see our map set right now. Thank you to Russo for designing that. We're in.
We're live here. It's your main man, Strom, and with me we've got the Bully.
That's right. Strom and the Bully coming at you live from stromboli.live. No, we are on Calzone.
I gotta go buy that domain, actually.
Great. Wonderful. All right, so we're here. Today we are going to be casting Da Boys versus No Weebs. I don't know much about either of these teams as teams. I know a little bit about some of their players. I mostly just recognize some of them. In fact, I recognize everybody on No Weebs except for Taz. And I recognize everybody on Da Boys, at least who's in right now, except for Magical.
We've played against Magical, though.
Beats me, dude.
we've played. Maybe you were out for that scrim. We definitely played against Magical, unless it's a different person with a similar name that I'm forgetting. But,
I doubt it. I doubt it.
Hit scan DPS player, at least when they're playing against us. Yep. Great Cubs in this lobby. So, what are your calls for this? Are we actually doing escort first, or is this just a broken lobby?
I believe it's just a broken lobby. If I am not mistaken, Nepal and Lejeune are our first map picks. We're going to be doing Koth first, as any good team would, or any good tournament would. You can't start the game off on a potential tie, and you want to save your escort map to the end. Don't want to start on a tie, don't want to end on a tie. All right. Right now, we're trying to determine which team gets to, I believe, pick map. They are struggling with it. There's something about
hard struggling.
Yeah, something about a coin flip or something. I don't know. It's just a reminder for everybody to get your water, hydrate. It's important.
Drinking that tea, not really hydrating. But, you know, it's tea.
It's got something. It's got water in it. We're going to say it counts.
Depends on the tea, I guess.
Yeah, that famous...
I mean, tea
no
has water
tea.
In it.
Yeah.
Water has... Or tea has water in it, but, like, some tea not good for hydrating.
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely.
This is very watered-down, lukewarm tea because I didn't have a lot of time to make the tea.
No, you did not.
Right before this broadcast.
Yes.
Still pretty good tea.
That's good.
So, what do you know about the Snowball Cup that we are casting here?
I know very little about it. I know it is a draft league, much like the Tournament of Kings Row, which a lot of these players have come from. Apparently my stream is still listed as offline. I don't know what that's about. Would you mind checking for me?
I'm checking for you.
Thank you. I'm going to actually be right back. I have started bleeding.
It says live right now.
That's good. I will be back in just a moment and I will handle that just to make sure everything's good.
Just doing a little bit of stream maintenance here.
All right, I'm back. Looks like we are actually live, so that's good.
Yep. As soon as you were checking was when we were going live.
Oh, okay.
The good old Stromboli in there.
Yeah,
The map set background looks good, but it looks like we're headed straight in for our first round on Nepal.
Yes, that seems like what we are going to be doing.
All right.
I'm going to pause our music. Gonna get our screen right. I believe that we're ready. We've got Da Boys on the right. Right now we've got Apple Expert, the Pigeon, Magical, Tom Curran, Kilo, and EMPN on the boys.
I think they've actually arranged them in 2-2-2 lock order here.
You know, as far as I can tell, it looks like that.
I don't know every player, but from what I do, people are in the correct role. So you've got tanks on the left, looks like main tanks far left, and then supports on the right, leaving your DPS players in the middle.
Correct.
So we've got good old Tom Curran apparently playing DPS in this league, not off tank. Been known to play both. Been known to cry about playing D.Va, though. But unsurprisingly, we're going to see very similar comps coming out from both sides. I wouldn't be surprised if Tom Curran, a.k.a. Stewie, is trolling us and is actually just going to play Doomfist and we'll have a mirror match.
Yep. I'm very curious to see what goes down here. Kilo on the Moira. I know he absolutely hates it. Get dunked on.
More and more fun in this meta. It's definitely like a more fun style brawl meta than Goats playing Moira, where like there's a lot of Goats, there's like a lot of sustained brawling, you know. This is definitely a lot more pick brawling.
All right, here we go, the mirror match. Everybody's trying to get into this pit right here. At least this is where they're playing deep.
Yeah,
that is a huge start. Nice start, taking out the main tank. Bob Ross
taking out the Doomfist.
Oh, sorry, I'm a dumbass. Don't worry.
Reading backwards.
I'm reading backwards. There we go.
All right, we got the second tank also falling. EMP. Yep. Classic gets two off the side.
Classic EMP. Well done, I must say.
Pew Pew here feeding a little bit. Maybe gets out.
I doubt it.
Yeah, just staggering himself a good bit. All right, so unfortunate start for the Weeb team here, but there wasn't anything like terribly wrong with their play there. They lost their main tank and they basically immediately lost. Let's see if they can turn it around in the second fight. The boys taking somewhat aggression here. Actually, Apple is calling them back to point, so they're just gonna fight on point here.
Apple was a late kill on the side of Du Bois, and so he's it's unsurprising that they had to hold back here. Stewie going on the Doomfist, or Tom Curran going in on the Doomfist rather.
Yeah, getting a first pick. You see Bob Ross trying to get a pick of his own, gets dangerously low though and pops out. Now they're trapped in this corner, and yeah, Du Bois are gonna take aggression on that with the coalescence. Get some late kills here. Push them back towards spawn. I don't see anybody else dying here unless they do something dumb.
No, me neither. What's really interesting to me about this meta is that losing your main tank isn't a death sentence, but it does mean that your Doomfist or Reaper has to get a kill right now.
Yeah. You
know, it means that your timeline is extremely accelerated.
Yeah. Well, it's kind of like you've got two main tanks. Like, at least you've got two shields, right?
Yep.
All right, big Sigma ult coming in to the enclosed area here. No kills directly coming out, and they can't follow up on it because the tanks are just standing in the door.
Poorly placed.
Yeah. I think it was finely placed. They just needed to run in the door afterwards, and they didn't. You know, it doesn't really matter, though, because they're going to clean this fight up very, very cleanly.
Yeah, an overinvestment of high-impact ults there from Du Bois, you know, so, Magical and Stewie.
You know, I think they're trying to keep him in spawn here because... Oh, they just lost the Reaper off the side. They can probably stop them from touching the point here. They've only got... Yeah. 4 seconds here. Probably Lucio running around the side to touch. I don't know if he's going to make it. Yeah. So, it wasn't overinvestment in ults, but they got him so late into that fight that they could hold aggressively to keep them from even touching.
Yep.
I do think their Lucio could have made something happen there if he took a more risky route, but probably
yeah, it wouldn't have mattered very much at all.
No, not have. All right. What do you expect to see swapped up here? We do see Magical over onto Symmetra, which I would like to see on this this point a little more than Reaper. Symmetra, such a terrible hero to play against.
Yeah, yeah, definitely puts a lot of shield pressure out, and Sigma has a really hard time dealing with it. You have to have Sigma who's very aware of what charge the Symmetra's at, and DPS that are very aware of that too, because you really don't want to let that Sim get to third level charge. Letting that Sim get to third level charge means you have no shield, Sigma just gets burned down.
Yeah, Sigma doesn't have a lot of health, and like can't use DM against Sim, so like you can burn that 400 health very easily as Symmetra. Alright, typical starting fight. No early picks yet. We see Doomfist going in left and right. Finally, they get a pick here aside of Du Bois, and that'll open up the fight very cleanly for them. EMP fragging out, getting two kills of his own.
Yep.
And we're gonna see just some desperate attempt to get like you know, some time on the clock, I guess. But nothing really coming out impressive there. We do see a swap over to the Pharah, Vegetal. Maybe looking to try and, you know, get a comfort pick or something here. Pharah pretty good. At least theoretically in this, you know, this meta, because not a lot of people who can do range damage against you. It's really the tanks who are gonna be shooting in your way.
Yeah, it's
just and they don't have burst damage.
It's gonna be all about farming up this barrage.
Yeah, I mean, barrage is a useful tool. Sigma has a lot of abilities that can deal with barrage well. So I don't necessarily think barrage is all Pharah is good for here. I play a lot of Pharah. Like,
yeah,
it's a little bit harder to get like picks unless you got people like this running away from the shields, because there are so many ways to just like get cover. But you can deal so much like damage pressure that people are stuck in one spot, and that can open it up for your second DPS to finish people.
What else do you think you're going to come out here? I mean, Vegetal built that barrage insanely quickly. But
oh yeah, you expect that on these tank lineups. But I think it's going to depend on how the Sigma plays. If they're aware that this Pharah has barrage, he can play, you know, a little bit more conservatively. But he's just going to throw out his ult here and hopefully kill them. And you see, Vegetal, knowing that, actually ults in the back line where there's no Sigma, but still dies for it because barrage just kills you. It's a shitty ult. I hate it.
This is
The Weebs trying to go in here, but have not been getting a lot of value out of this Doomfist.
No, they haven't. Yeah, you see there, I mean, that was pretty... It seemed like it could have been just late staggers, like it's just a dumb res, but it got out the Bongo and the wall from Du Bois.
Yeah, and they've got support ults left. Unfortunately, coming into this, the Weebs don't have anything other than support ults as well. Falcon Nano, pretty good. They need to really get in and disrupt this tank line, because that's... Their Doomfist has been trying, but he's just been dying every time. Happens again. They have no DPS now.
Yep. This is, there's not much to say here. I think a big part of this, you know, the tanks on the side of Du Bois, obviously very good. They're doing a very good job. But the DPS on the side of No Weebs just didn't do anything. And it could just be because, you know, they didn't have space. EMP, of course, getting our play of the game.
His early two boot, probably.
Yep.
Just follows him around here, jumps over the top. Shoots straight down, which of course sends them outwards.
Of course, yeah. That's the only way that it
Overwatch, a logical game.
All right. Let's get us back to our map set screen. Looks like we're doing pretty good here. That's 2-0 in favor of Du Bois. Smilers 2, as some are calling.
Alright, so they're subbing out Bob Ross here. I've heard this version of Bob Ross is a Doomfist one trick. A little bit unimpressive to call what he was doing a trick, but he wasn't really able to... He was able to get in, but unfortunately it was only him in, and, you know, Du Bois seemed pretty good at locking down once he got in there. Wasn't able to get out, wasn't able to get value.
Yep. To those of you just joining us, you can see it on your screen. It is 2-0 on the control map in favor of Du Bois. Pretty clean. Really not much to be said there. You know, it's just very clean play there from Du Bois. And there was just not a lot of value gotten out for the DPS on the side of No Weebs. What I think was going on there was just that... The DPS didn't understand their role. You know, they were just trying to go for, you know, damage, not kills, not flanks, you know, not taking space that isn't occupied. That's what it seemed like to me. I could be wrong.
Yeah, it seemed like that Doomfist a lot of times was trying to, like, start up a fight. Occasionally it was at the wrong time, but I think a majority of the time he was trying to start a fight at the right time. He just wasn't getting value on the targets that he was hitting. I don't know if that was, like, a mechanical issue, like he was, you know, like, getting blocked... The positioning was a little bit better, or it was just, you know, good play from tanks. But he would punch in and get somebody pretty low, but he wasn't able to finish off any kills. And by the, like, he either used up all his cooldowns, or some cooldowns were used on him, and he just died. And that's very, very different to if you saw Du Bois go in, like, their Doomfist was consistently picking off somebody to start the fight, and then they collapsed. They were almost never able to get a pick to start the fight for the side of No Weebs.
All right, and it looks like we're going to be going to Hanamura here.
Oh, love that map.
Yeah, it's gonna be good. All right.
Pro tip for your stream, please turn on health bars.
Ah, yes, thank you. Thank you very much.
So, no swaps for Du Bois. We do have, like I said, Bob Ross / Stanley being subbed out. I wonder if that means they have a better Doomfist player or they're just off the Doomfist. Like I said, they were having a lot of trouble initiating fights with Doomfist last round, so maybe they're going for a different strategy here. Yep. Maybe they're going for a Bastion on Hanamura defense.
Yeah, Bunker's definitely an option here. This is also, if I know Kilo and EMP and those boys, they're going to try to sim telly to point. You know, I that's how Smilers likes to do it, so I wouldn't be surprised if this team, which has three Smilers players in right now, it's just going to go.
They don't have any of the people who normally play Sim, so it's usually me, Fortle, or Oase playing Sim.
Yeah, I'm very curious.
I bet Sui, like, I'm certain somebody on the team can play it.
Yeah, it's not hard. Yeah. Not too hard.
So we're going to see, actually, some different comps coming out here. We have Pharah Mei, side of No Weebs, on defense. I'm not a fan of the defense of Pharah on this point, just, like, in terms of my own comfort. But we'll see if it works out. And we've got a McCree coming out on attack, which is strange. I know Magical, at least when he's playing against us, comfortable on the hit scan, so maybe that's a comfort pick for him too. But it's going to be rough for this far, I imagine.
I'm curious to see if he sticks it. You know, Tom Curran is sticking on the Junkrat for now.
I think that's a troll.
I think it's a troll as well, which makes me think that maybe Magical is also trolling. Yep, there we go. But if Magical is coming out of the McCree, maybe Jubby is just a Pharah one trick. Maybe this is something that they expect. A hold direct from point for Noeebs. Let me get us over onto the correct.
Where's that Pharah going to hang out? They're holding directly from point. I guess you can hang off to the side. There's a lot of windows here. Pharah shooting through windows is not a bad strategy on some of these King of the Hill maps or 2CP. But, yeah. Tom Curran going and gets very low, but gets out. No finish from the side of Noeebs. But they
not sure how he got
start. He peeked a little bit in front of the shield and, you know, power boosted Pharah, not something you fuck around with really easily.
Yeah, absolutely not. Epic Shot cleaning up two there, you know, obviously had a lot of help. You can see it from the kill feed. Vegetal, you know, they won this fight, but Vegetal's walls, I don't know, maybe I just misunderstood the purpose. They look like isolation walls that missed. I mean, Apple was on top of them every time.
whatever happened there, it at least disoriented Du Bois, and they were able to get some clean kills. Didn't lose anybody on the side of Nobis.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, Jubby almost has this barrage. Octo has the window. Yeah,
I'd like to see a really early barrage here.
There it is! That's all we wanted! Beautiful.
Yeah, no time for the Sigma to even react. There's a beautiful combo with the pull from Orisa, getting them all into one spot, and that's an easy quad kill. Oh, they might finish this Mercy. EMP dies very late there at the end, getting sniped basically in the spawn door.
Yep. Let me.
Yeah, that's going to kill. They're going to be down to 2 minutes from thinking even touch the point here, and they really don't have anything to show for it. No ults. They've changed up characters here. They've got Coalescence, but it's not really a fight winning ultimate. It's useful. But on the side of Noeebs, they have the window from Baptiste, which can give them some even more pressure here. Yeah, they're just going to basically zone out the door.
That's good. I mean, it might not secure any kills. Oh, Jubby playing super aggressive during this time when they're just zoning. Yeah,
that's a throw there. You already have them not attacking point. You don't need to be going for picks. And now the 4-on-6. I don't see it winnable here for Noeebs. Huge blizzard coming out.
Huge blizzard.
Making me eat my words.
Absolutely, yep.
The spawn advantage, though, is going to be rough here. Magical's got 3 shots from the corner.
They're still cleaning this up. EMP and Kilo just going in on their own, carrying this. Yeah. Good stuff. Love to see it.
All right. Yeah, Noeebs, too much over-aggression from the pharmacy. Yeah. You're not invincible, and they had a hit scan up, so like you shouldn't be peeking there.
Yeah, absolutely. That was definitely a throw play from Jubby. You know, it seems like it was just uncoordinated with what the team wanted to do.
All right, so now we've got some Widow on Widow action. Vegetal swapping over to the Widow. Magical maybe sticking here. You can get some good sight lines through these windows. Unfortunately for him, a lot of the heads are stuck behind an Orisa shield right now, so he's going to have to be looking for that Pharah. And I wonder if Vegetal is just here to countersnipe. You see him finishing off Stewie up in the stairs, but it's really hard to get sight lines into the stairwells, Widow, unless you go over there like he's doing
now. Du Bois needs to be out right now.
Yeah. Okay, I think we take those. Barrage builds really quickly,
but still.
Even so, yeah.
Apparently we're still on overlay?
We shouldn't be anymore. It was 3 minutes ago.
Never mind.
Don't worry about it.
Yeah. Scuffs chat.
Yes, I've been keeping an eye on it. Don't worry, everybody. It was close, but I have.
You need to update score, though, bro.
I already did.
Well, 3 minutes ago, you didn't.
3 minutes ago, I had. Don't worry. Don't worry, everybody.
All right. We have ult coming out from Magical here. No counter from Vegetal available. All right, they're going to combo the Doomfist and Sigma here.
But the Lamp's still alive. Well.
Yeah, I think.
Yeah.
They get a bunch of kills here, but it's not super clean. I imagine a tick or two, but that's it.
Yeah, we'll see. We'll see. I like the Valkyrie here. It's just Jubby needs to stay alive.
Yeah, and they're getting some contest out of this Valkyrie Mercy, also keeping the Far alive, and that gives them time to bring in their reinforcements. Yeah. DuBois had already lost a couple to start that fight, so it was going to be rough for them to, you know, have the longevity to get three ticks.
Yeah, it was very interesting. You know, there was a lot of red in the kill feed, but they were all deployables. You know, we saw the Bongo get killed, we saw the Lamp get killed, but it didn't it didn't actually, you know, kill anyone.
Yeah, there was some action going on like away from top where they lost some to trades basically, and that meant they weren't gonna have the staying power to get the full cap here. All right, and we see a different setup here. Doomfist actually on the high ground left side with the attackers. Wonder what he's looking for in terms of picks. He might be trying to scout this Widow. He's going to go back and support his team when the Widow's kind of zoned out here. So DuBois kind of trapped in the sterile right now by, you know, opposite side Far and Doomfist.
Ooh.
And they collapse on the Magical's Widow, and that's going to make it tougher.
That was a very good lead on how Magical was set.
Yeah, Magical, I think, was hoping his team to apply pressure, but they were still getting in place. He was out of position.
Yeah.
Jubby dropping a little bit low here, gets his Mercy though, and goes for another barrage.
Another barrage. Yep. I think it's worth it.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah.
If they kill Apple, they stagger Apple another 5 seconds or so.
Yeah.
So I'm currently going to get on the Doomfist, but it's looking rough. They're down to maybe two pushes here, and they have a bunch of ults that will be available after this push, or if they make a long fight here. But yeah. It's looking like it's going to get down to overtime if they do cap.
Magical back on the Symmetra. He was briefly on the McCree. I'm not sure.
I think
sure.
He just swapped double there. I don't think he was ever shooting on McCree.
I missed it then.
Alright. Good aggression on the point. They don't get the second tick for free. And Vengeful's going to get a quick pick on Kilo in the back line. Yeah, this is a cleanup from No Weaves.
Yep. No Weaves looking a lot better here. Not just getting
they've stabilized on second point. They used one ult there, but they're gonna have the Sigma ult for the last fight and Valkyrie. So they're gonna be running into a couple more ults on the other side, but I just think Sigma ult's really powerful for like last ditch holds.
Absolutely.
You can separate out so many people for long enough to kind of get the numbers you need for a last point hold. So. The Pigeon probably going to have his ult before they touch the point here, so it's going to be a question of who uses it better, I think. Pigeon punched off the point by their Doomfist, and that's going to leave it open here. I don't like how even this fight is going.
Yeah, it's not good for DuBois.
No Weaves are down right now, but not by enough, maybe.
That's good. Yeah, the Doomfist returning in, that definitely helps a lot. We'll see if he can continue getting the value.
For sure. They've got four on point now from No Weaves, and if they don't get a pick here soon from DuBois, it's going to be rough. Yeah, two down, this is over.
Yeah, especially if the Doomfist is down, you lost all of your damage. Everybody else is essentially sustained here.
Yeah.
You know, Soldier trying to run back, you know, EMP doing his best to stall. But that's going to be it. That's 2 points. That's two ticks, pretty much on the nose.
Vegetal getting some really clutch picks on the second point. And like a lot of different fights here.
Yep.
Chubby J also using barrages so well.
Yeah, yeah.
Only died in like a third of them.
Yeah, I definitely think that the DPS are looking a lot better on the side of No Weebs this time. You know, and that's a motto I can really appreciate, you know, not having Weebs.
And you know what? I'm looking at your stream, just thinking back, and you still didn't have health bars on.
I was certain that I did, but seems like I didn't. That's fine.
I'm gonna need you to press that tilde key right quick.
I'm gonna wait until they spawn. I think that's what's happened to me because I pressed it before they spawned, and that may have been what happened. No worries. We'll continue. All right,
so the boy is moving on to defense. They need to hold second before, you know, basically the second tick. What do you see them doing here on first point?
You know, I really couldn't tell you for sure. It seems like they want to do the tele straight to point strat for the attacking team.
Yeah.
But the defense.
They're doing the Bastion.
On the Bastion. I like it.
I do too.
Yeah, Pigeon's play has been pretty good. Apple's play is exceptional. And so I think that, you know, with those two, Tom Curran's not going to have much issue, you know, finding free space.
Yeah. Yeah, they are going up against a lot of pressure here. Pharah Symmetra, I think, can cause some trouble for Bastion. Because Symmetra, if she gets behind your shield, you're basically donezo. And, okay, they're going on the Mei, actually, which is also another reasonable attempt against the Bastion.
So this Tele is pretty good. It allows Tom Curran to rotate without actually having to get out of turret form, and both sides of it are covered, so long as these shields don't move. They Tele straight to point, as expected.
But, yeah, the Bastion's in a good spot to shoot them where they Tele on point.
Yeah.
They're using the Bell for cover, and... it's not going to be enough. Big nade coming out, actually, from EMP.
Absolutely. Yeah.
And Tom Curran will teabag this Porch. All right, it looks like we might be seeing, we're going to be seeing Sombra and Genji to counter the Bastion. A pretty common tactic. It is just miserable trying to do it until you get the ultimates. And we don't actually see an Ana coming out. So you can run this without Ana, because EMP and Blade together are hopefully guaranteed kills, but the Nano doesn't hurt either.
Yep. I'm very curious to see if the Sombra and the Genji are able to get any value. I mean, it's so hard to get value around these shields as either Sombra or Genji. That being said, Tom Curran gets hacked. So clearly at least some value.
I mean, it wasn't really value. He died hacking him, so. Yep. And they're just going to TP the Bastion back, shred the crap out of them. And at this rate, they're not going to build fast enough to cap. Like, this Genji needs to be just suiciding into people, almost, getting damage in. He does there, up to 50%, but their Sombra's at 27% after a minute.
Yep. Like I said, it's going to be extremely difficult for that Sombra to get value.
I mean, they don't need to get value in the traditional sense. They don't need to kill anybody. They don't even need to get space. They just need to shoot bullets into a tank.
Yeah.
And right now, Vegetal's sitting here trying to find a good angle to maybe shoot through the window. But, it's just getting destroyed by Sim turrets. And we see some investment here. Simball is going to come out from Du Bois. And they're going to invest Blade, I think, which is fine as an attempt, because they're not going to build EMP.
Yeah, you can. Yeah, they haven't killed the Bastion. Vegetal, Vegetal swapping over to the Doomfist. We'll see what Jubby swaps onto. I don't know. I think we're going to see some really weird shit. Yeah. Jubby seemed like they were most comfortable on the Pharah.
Yeah, I mean, they didn't play a bad Genji, just Vegetal was not doing much there on the Sombra. Yeah. They're still running the ball D.Va, which is, you know, as far as tanks go, not terrible against Bastion. D.Va probably the most useful here against Bastion.
Taking out Pigeon early.
The
Koa's
going to sustain them, but not... Koa cannot sustain Bastion. Like,
especially not
they
Bastion.
They need to either zone him out or kill him. And they haven't really done either at this point. Wasted ult from Tom Curran.
Checks out.
He'll gonna finish off a bunch of kills there. Yep. Gets three himself.
Yeah. Not a lot of stuff looking... not a lot of ults on either side. Epic's going to have that minefield, but is it going to get any value? It's gonna
be tough. Can you spin around the bell on this point? I'm not a Hammond player.
You can if you're good. Tight. It's very tight.
It's tough. I mean, if you can get a minefield on point and spin to maybe zone out people that are not Bastion...
maybe.
They've got Vegetal on Widow who can maybe just, you know, shoot from far range, get a good angle on the Bastion, but they have yet to kill the Bastion before the fight's over, and that's been kind of their downfall. They minefield in the Bastion?
Minefield, but yeah, this is what I was expecting. I was expecting Healer to just hold that immortality field.
Yeah. Yep, and that's an easy fight cleanup.
Easy fight win.
Alright, the healers for Noweebs need to get out right now immediately. Okay. They've got Pew Pew in place so they can get a last point touch, but
That's got to be a fat finger. It's got to be. There's no way it's not.
He was coming from Swan. It's going to last till the end of the game. So.
All right, never mind. Doesn't matter if it's a fat finger. All right, there we go. Second point. That was point, fast. It's 2-0 right now on the side of Dubois. Good stuff.
Yeah. All right. Are we only going to halftime here?
Yep. I'm going to watch this play of the game. I believe it's going to be right outside spawn doors. Yep. Oh, the nice
good team coordination.
Yeah, absolutely. I wish I could remember that I had teammates to do that as Orisa.
And then some pretty average far play there from both sides.
All right, there we go. Let me get us onto our map set screen. Update our score. That was a 0-2 on Hanamura. If this doesn't work, I'm blaming Russo. Russo built this. That works. All right, that looks good. Okie dokes. 0-2 for Dubois. Good stuff. Good stuff.
This is regular league play, right? This isn't the best of three?
Yes, this is regular league play, so we're going to be playing four maps, a fifth one if, well, we go into reverse sweep territory, essentially.
I wouldn't bet any money on that, to be honest with you.
I wouldn't either, but I was more impressed than I expected to be on that second point. I think Jubby plays a very aggressive Pharah, which obviously got punished more than once.
It got punished hard once. Like, there were more things wrong with that team setup than him getting punished.
Agreed, totally agreed. I'm just very curious to see how he plays moving forward, if he does continue to play. Vegetal seems to be, I don't know, both on Hanamura and on, what was it, Nepal? Yes, Nepal. Vegetal seemed to be having a hard time finding value.
He swapped over on that attack run three or four times and didn't really come up with anything on any of the heroes he was on.
Yeah, I was watching EMP. EMP was definitely protecting his backline with Lucio boops on Nepal more than on Hanamura. I don't think he played Lucio very much on Hanamura. And then the tanks are doing a very good job of making sure that Vegetal doesn't get value. So...
And he still didn't have health bars on.
Well,
people are roasting your spectating right now.
I know. Oh, well. That's okay. Oh, well.
Yeah. Yeah, I don't like watching point of view spectating.
Yeah, nor do I. People like to see the flashy mechanical plays, but it really doesn't matter if a Widow, is looking at the other Widow. We know that's happening. Yeah. I think that's what DPS.
Yeah, there's a big problem with that because people want to see flashy plays, which means you want to be speccing a DPS, but then you get like nothing except you get like tunnel vision basically.
Yeah, so precisely.
For the best, you want to be like spectating an Ana in the back line or a tank or something like that, and theirs is just boring as shit.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, you get a better sense of the fight, but you don't get a very good spectator experience, I suppose.
Yeah. And God forbid you spectate like a Genji or Doomfist and you just get a seizure.
Yep, absolutely. Yeah, the way I think it probably is DPS players like to watch POVs because, DPS players
and they don't care about the fight.
Yeah, they just care about the kills, not the fight. Get dunked on, DPS players. Don't at me. All right, it looks like our next map is going to be King's Row. I'm excited.
Update the score for Hannah Montana.
I will. Let's see. King's Row. All right, let me make sure that came out right. All right, 0-0. We're going to King's Row. I'm excited. Let's see. And I'm going to wait for that to actually
go. Was it a 2-0? Does it count as a 2-0 or a 1-0?
They
didn't count second.
I probably just put in the wrong number.
Yeah, it's 0-1. That's okay. Yeah, chat's roasting you now.
That's okay. Put it in 1. It's a win. Who cares? All right. Cool. Did I update that? Did that actually come out? Yeah, we're good. See, it's rough because we're on a 3-minute delay, so I don't actually notice mistakes until 3 minutes later when y'all tell me about them.
Now entering King's Row.
And I'll be honest, I've been drinking today. All right, and we are going into King's Row. Let me update real quick. Dubois.
Make sure you remove the overlay too,
For
when we go into this match. And turn on health bars.
Alright, I'm hitting Tilda right at this very second. I did it.
I'll check in 3 minutes.
It's going to be 3 minutes and 17 seconds. Alright, so what do you expect to see here? I'm expecting more Risa Sigma, obviously. I think we're definitely going to see Doom. I think we're definitely going to see Pharah. I think one.
I want to see some Super Monkey Ball, but I don't think we're gonna.
I don't think we're gonna see it either. You know, it just doesn't. It's hard to get value as with the same DPS on this map. I think when you're running Super Monkey Ball, you don't have anywhere safe to retreat to.
It's also risky because Mei is pretty common on defense here. Yep. Mei makes Ball less fun.
Mei makes Ball not fun. Easy. Yep, this is what we expected. Oh, there's a too easy call out coming from Vegetal here. Is it Vegetal? You're down 2-0, bud. You're down 2-0, bud.
He didn't say it was easy to win.
That's true. He just said it was too easy. All right. And Tom Kearney will be coming out on the Widow. It's guaranteed just to try to get a free shot off.
Yeah. Especially because Tom Kearney not known as a hitscan player. At least when we play with him. Attackers incoming. Let's see what happens here. Nobody's really peeking for the Widow.
Yep,
he swaps into the Pharah. I like Pharah on attack on this map because there's lots of good angular cover around the point. This hotel provides a lot of space where you can kind of peek and shoot. Reaper teleporting up top trying to kill the Pharah might do so.
He does it! And is punished for it. That's a play I've seen before. Rezzed up, but EMP dies for it. Yeah, rotation through hotel gets kind of split off. If they just survive here, this will be fine. They just can't aggress right now. They have switched their Doomfist player. Oof. Tom Kearney taken out again.
Yeah. Looking a bit rough in pharmacy here. That Reaper, some pretty good strats coming in. Teleporting on top of the head of the statue and dropping right on the Pharah. All right.
A halt, not getting a lot. I'm really curious to see how a whiff rock.
And Tom Kearney again down to the Reaper. Blizzard committed here.
Blizzard,
I'm not sure if they needed it, but it's a pretty good fight cleanup, and they actually lose their Sigma in the process, so maybe it was good. They finally spot out this Reaper teleporting into their face and pressure them out.
Oof.
Oh, late kill onto EMP. Good shot. By Jubby from Mei.
Yep. Tom Kearney, knowing he wasn't getting value on the Pharah, swapping over to the Doomfist. I definitely think that's worthwhile. Magical had to swap off of the Doomfist for him to get to it, though.
Yeah, it's fair.
Yeah. I don't know if there was much.
See how they're putting a TP bomb in here. It looks like get some ult charge for that Sim, but teleporter's killed pretty quickly.
Yeah. All right, Death Blossom up and Death Blossom out.
No value.
Yeah, no value. That's all right. He was trying to get something out of it. Apple super low.
And purple. A good nade coming out from Octo, but
nice halt flux combo. Do they finish it up though? No, the nade very good. Yeah. All right, there it is.
I mean, this fight was just it was already over.
It was a formality.
Yeah. See how many ults they can maybe get out of Du Bois. That's not a terrible first point hold. They got 2.5 minutes off the clock.
Absolutely not. It's definitely worthwhile.
They still got some ults in their pocket here to maybe make a hold on streets. As long as WJ doesn't get picked here. Alright. It's out.
Yeah. Like I said before, very aggressive player, very aggressive DPS. Which works great if your tanks are also aggressive, but seems just a little bit more aggressive than the rest of his team might have to play with. And I mean, it's doing well so far. Doing fine.
I did check your stream and we do have health bars, so we're good to go. All right, a trade coming out. Still pretty even fight here. Supercharger out from the side of no weebs, but yeah, okay. There they get the value. Mei getting some good shots in, and they're gonna commit another Blizzard here. And you know, it might have been worth it because they lost two somehow in the Blizzard.
Yeah.
And they're letting Magical run on their back line. Melt Epic Shock here.
A nano to keep Epic Shock alive.
Yeah, and they can't like actually get Du Bois out of this spot here. They're playing still pretty passively. They're missing their Mei, but you know, I somehow feel the Doomfist could do something like that. Punch Lucio into a fucking cart.
Tom Curran tries to retaliate, gets nothing for it.
Magical playing super aggressive, just outside the range of the immortality field.
Yeah.
Inches.
That was just a little bit too much. They're not up here. They don't have their second healer.
Yeah. They need to be out right now. They can't win this.
They can't win this, but they've actually had a lot of cart presence here, and even though they've been like either even or losing fights, they made it around a couple corners.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, you know, they made all the way around this bend just with a losing fight.
Yeah. Or at least an even fight. Yeah. And what that means for them is they really only need one fast wipe here to get it, you know, in danger of capping. Which I think is good for them. If you look at their ults coming up, they've got the Doomfist Sigma combo, and they've got both support ults to make it happen.
Yep.
I'm not sure they even need all four, but let's see what the side of No Weed's gonna throw out. They're gonna throw out their Sigma ult real early here. Counter by beat probably won't do much here. They also throw out Immortality, which maybe is the overcommitment of support here. Yeah.
There are a lot of ults being used here. It is.
Yeah, surprisingly little coming out from the Sigma Doom combo from Du Bois. And it's much more even fight than I thought it should have been here. Square is going to come out from both sides, and they're just going to shoot each other's face until they get somewhere. And it seems like No Weeps has superior people shooting through the square. And
yep. No Weeps absolutely does, yeah. Kilo just staggering himself here. Well known for that.
No, he's got support.
Oh, he has more team coming back in. That Telly probably got him closer.
Yeah, Telly coming in clutch here. I think No Weaves wasn't actually ready for them to be here that soon.
Yeah, I clearly wasn't.
They didn't have their Orisa, but like the rest of the people here were available and just spreading out, so they weren't all going to get picked. Big purple coming out again from Octo. It's going to allow them to clean up some of the back line. All right, good Maywall. I'm gonna separate out Kilo, and maybe we'll see an end to this fight that's been going on for 2 minutes.
Yeah, this
Apple trying to retreat here, getting shot by Sigma, but I don't see anything coming of that. And Sigma getting pocketed a little. Last fight territory here for Du Bois, and they're gonna get blizzarded. Oh
no, they don't! Huge eat from Pigeon,
and they're gonna counter that with a Sigma ult and hopefully go in on it. Big wall coming out, giving them some space to do their range damage. Doomfist ult doesn't get any value.
And too many shields on the board. Wouldn't have done much.
Way too many.
Yep.
Epic shot again falling. Come on. This looks to be a second point cap by Du Bois.
Yep.
Solid point coming out from support players, but I don't think anything's going to happen here. Cool.
All right. There we go. All
right. We're on to third point. Not a lot of time on the clock for Du Bois. And we should have time for No Weaves to build some good ult combos here to get them off the payload the one time they need. We'll see if they take a contest at the corner. They're going to have to get there real fast if they want to. And it seems like they want to hold on the final straight away.
They're moving up to corner now. They just wanted to make sure their healers were in line of sight to help them.
Oh, no, I know they're holding here, but they didn't want to hold first corner.
Oh, yeah, no, there was no way they were getting that. Absolutely.
Yeah. Sigma ult coming out. Don't get a lot of value on the Orisa there.
Yeah.
Yeah, they beat it anyways, so maybe they get beat out of it, I guess. They're gonna get run over, basically no matter what, after that. So both support ults come in here. We're gonna need Epic Shock or somebody to do the needful and stall the point. JubbyJ's really close to the Blizzard. So if they can get the clock down another 10-15 seconds and then throw a Blizzard on point, they've got a good chance at winning the fight, but Edgel already down to Magical. Good stall coming out. They haven't built the Blizzard as fast as I thought they would.
Yeah, there's been a lot of...
Now they're at hard stall territory. Even if they get a Blizzard here, they're going to need more people.
Flux from Pigeon.
And the Blizzard comes out with everybody dead.
The and frozen
notably,
push
3.9 seconds still on the clock. They did not get it down to zero. So even if they push all the way, we're going to another round.
All right. There we go. A nice round one. Du Bois do push it all the way through. Good for them. Good for them. So do you think there's going to be anything weird coming out from the side of No Weebs or Du Bois?
No.
I don't
think so. This is not a meta, really, for weird heroes. I mean, compared to other metas, there have been some weird hero picks, like Reaper being prominent. But, and, you know, Symmetra.
Yeah.
I think we'll probably see some flavor of May, Reaper, maybe Doomfist on defense with the Sigma and the Orisa. Maybe a BAP on defense. This map a little bit more, a little bit better for BAP. Yeah, we see the BAP Ana, actually.
Yeah.
And the weirdest thing we have, surprisingly, is a Hanzo pick from Magical.
Yeah, yeah. I don't think that we're going to see what we're seeing coming here from Noweebs all the way out. But Magical, yeah, that Hanzo, very interesting. If he's confident in it and he can land these shots on the Pharah, then that'd be interesting. There's no way that there's a mirrored Hanzo. I would never believe it.
I mean, they could have probably seen the Hanzo from up here. Magical showing his hand. They might be using it to get the sight arrow out the door, or not. They're just trolling us.
No, well, Jubby got sonic themselves, so they didn't want to stay up there and risk getting headshot, which, reasonable.
Yep. Alright, we are not going to be seeing the Brig, unfortunately. We will see the Moira come out, and then the Pharmacy. Pretty typical when you're running Pharmacy. Moira able to deal a lot of healing in the close quarters, where people are gathered behind the shields, and Far and Mercy combo since the beginning of this game. Magical doming Vegetal as he comes around the corner. It's gonna be a good start.
Maybe this is why we see the Hanzo pick.
Yeah, maybe. They're gonna actually get in place to res. They didn't think to cover that, or maybe didn't have the manpower. So, full fight coming back in force. Yeah. Only takes about 10 seconds off the clock there. Pew Pew dangerously low on the Mercy. We'll get filled up. Never mind, EMP will get the pick. And that leaves Jubby kind of all alone here. Moira not good at healing.
He'll be pushed by the Reaper here.
Yeah, but I don't see him getting the actual kill on Kilo. He's got so much healing coming out from his nade and EMP. The healers here from Du Bois playing in pretty good positions. They're up on high ground, and they've got a lot of cover to dip behind if the Pharah starts to come near them. They're also two of the best healers for, you know, shooting at a Pharah. Is working out well on this point.
Apple doing a very good job of using his halts to combo with other people's abilities. You know, we've seen several shots from Magical land because he shoots a halt. The last time that Jubby died was because of the halt shot from...
Ooh! Magical caught away from the shields, and they're gonna run right over him. That's gonna open up a lot of space for them. Apple stuck in the corner too. They couldn't really get the healers into that corner spot. They were trapped behind some of the walls here. That's going to be a pretty good fight coming out by Noreebs. Tom Curran stalling. I don't see anybody getting back here. And that leaves them with better time on the clock on the first point than Du Bois did.
Somebody needs to save healer.
About 20 seconds ahead of where they were. Alright, let's see how streets go here. They have built up the barrage and the Beyblade. EMP taking a rock in the back line.
Yep.
So, if they can get either of those to be high value, they can probably take streets. Bongo coming out early from Du Bois, maybe trying to build up some ults of their own. They're going to get Dragon and Sigma ult, it seems, along with their support ults.
A halt Dragon would be a low tier investment, I think, that could, that could yield
around one of these. One of these corners, they can separate out some of the tanks or some of the DPS. Here it's going to go.
There it is.
Dragon separates out the Sigma, and it had Vegetal in the back line commit his ult.
Yeah, Vegetal didn't get what he needed there, yeah.
Yeah. They're still holding on to Barrage here. Still need to be a little bit careful with Sigma. A halt Barrage coming out from their weeps could be actually pretty deadly. And we'll see Sigma ult committed.
Oof.
Yeah, a good thought from Jubby while the Sigma is busy ulting to try and get in the back line, but they were paying attention and he got shot in the face for it. They'll nano the Doom here to just go in and shoot at tanks, I guess.
Lose the fight. I don't know if that was the intended target or not.
Yeah. Maybe a questionable heat of the moment decision, because it really felt like they were winning that fight, but they never were able to get literally Epic Shock out of position. He was just slowly creeping in. Magical, another good shot on that Pharah.
Yeah.
But they'll lose EMP in the back line to the Reaper, and this is getting really, really close to second being held here.
Nice nade from Kilo, keeping Pigeon up.
Alright.
Should be a nice hold.
Yeah. Nice is not the way I would describe that. A little bit messy as they're rounding the kind of last corner here. Messy from both sides, but yeah. We'll have an ult advantage a little bit coming out from Du Bois. Yep. But they've got 2 minutes on the clock, and remember, Du Bois, when they were attacking, barely capped second, and they had to push with a minute and a half left on third. So if they can take it in one or two fights here, they'll be ahead in time, but third point's pretty rough to cap, even if you do have that full minute and a half.
I think we're going to see another Halt Dragon here early from Apple and Magical.
Yeah, I'd like to see it again as they round this corner, try and separate someone out, and that's what they did. They don't get any separations, but the Doomfist is going to commit anyways.
Yeah. Definitely.
And they'll throw out Bongo and Window. And yeah, okay, rightfully so. We see the entirety of Noeeb's just piece the fuck out. They'll wait the 10 seconds.
Yeah, that was, you know, you could have staggered those a little bit, but that's all right.
Yeah, they still had 3 ults in the bank, so I'm not going to roast them for it.
Yeah.
They'll drop the Doomfist and Sigma ult there and still don't get any kills. Very, very low Taz's on the Sigma. And now, bad ult economy for Du Bois. They've got Nano and that's it.
Yeah, they did not get
the Nano something big here. They'll Nano the Doom again. He's unable to stop the res, but he does kill the Mercy for it. Here are the picks coming in for that Doomfist. Tom Curran chasing down the back line. Warrior's gonna get out, but Epic Shock's dead body is just collapsing on the payload right now. Alright, so we're gonna go into maybe the last fight of second point here. And it's looking good for Noeebs on ult economy. What do you expect to see them start with?
Oh, I excuse me. I think that they're probably going to bust out the barrage early and block it with a Sigma shield just to make sure that Magical doesn't land another headshot. Magical has been dealing with Jubby like Magical playing Hitscan. It's been really impressive.
Yeah. That coordinating that Sigma shield, like you said, I think is very hard. They actually just broke the Sigma shield. The boys have none, and Vegetal's going to go in. Gets one with his ult and dies. I think they take that. They've had a lot of trouble getting value out of the Reaper ults. And, oh my god. They also trade one for the Pharah ult. And they're going to build the dragon in the meantime, and that will basically clean up this fight.
Yep, all right. That's it. All right.
Magical dropping kids on this Anzo, and that will be a victory for Du Bois.
Definitely a comfort pick there for Magical. That's you know, we were curious at the start, now I think we understand. All right.
Definitely understand. And I, going into that last fight, I felt pretty good about the chances of Noeebs taking second. But you know, they invested the Reaper ult and got one, which is not exactly what you want, but it's good enough. But they also got that out of the barrage, and so they essentially used 2 ults and nothing to speak for it, as the fight was still even. And unfortunately, that allowed Magical to build Dragon and kind of end that fight where it stood. Alright, congratulations to Du Bois. Yep. They're going to be taking this series at least 3-1, but potentially 4-0 based on the trends.
Yep, alright, beautiful. Excuse me. All right. So let's see. The last 2 maps in our map pool are Gibraltar and Rialto. We will not be seeing a 5th map, unfortunately. Gibraltar, Rialto. I love Gibraltar. I've not played Rialto in this meta with a team. It's not in our map pool, so I don't know how to play it. Yeah, but that's the one we're going to see. We are going to Rialto, everybody. Let me set that up. All right. Looking good. All right. I hope everybody's excited. We are we're seeing a sub here. Apple Expert is going to be coming out for Master Dempsey. I don't know anything about them. Exotic is going to be coming in for Octo, it looks like. And that's all the subs I see thus far. I'll keep you posted if there's any others.
All right. Interesting. Do you know anything about Master Dempsey?
Not a clue.
I wonder if he's a Rhine expert. I'm hoping.
God, if
we think we see some goats too. It could also just be putting in the second string because they've already won.
Yep, that's absolutely what it is. Yeah,
but I would expect to see Tyranitar in. You know,
that's true. That's true. Maybe Tyranitar is,
or you know, if this guy even is a main tank player, I would expect their second string to be Rockney, or maybe Rockney's the first string and he's AFK. Both Rockney and Apple both pretty solid main tanks, at least from when we've scrimmed against them.
Yeah, Rockney does fine if I recall correctly, but I wouldn't put money on that.
Yeah.
All right. Now we're just waiting. I don't know what we're waiting on. All right, Du Bois with the win. Good for them. Smilers too. I mean, the boys go for the win.
The smiling boys.
The smiling boys go for the win. Good for them. Smilers with a better main tank. I love it. I don't have chat pulled up. Let me pull it up. See what's going on. I'm getting calls for ready from Du Bois. All right, we are entering Rialto.
Welcome to Rialto.
Oh, goodness. All right, let me get us to.
Initiating match.
Here, give me a second to update the score line, and then we will be ready to rock. Oop, that's not what I wanted. Not what I wanted either. My goodness, y'all. Struggling. All right. We are in 3-0 Du Bois over No Weebs. We have 7 seconds till this game starts. Which is good, because Overwatch League started 1 minute ago, if I'm not mistaken. So hopefully this match will end up quickly, so all of us can go watch some good Overwatch instead of our scuffed casting. I hope you guys have enjoyed it. I know that some of you have very clearly not. That's fine. I'm allowed to be bad at what I do.
It's true. You frequently are.
Damn, got me good.
All right, and we do see, hopefully, Goats 2 coming out from Du Bois. They've got at least Rein, Zarya, and some bullshit for DPS.
Yeah. I don't think we're going to see anything real.
That's so sad. I do really like Rein, Zarya on this map. It's so fun to play. At least it used to be.
Oh, all right. And we have a pause. Smiler's pause strat.
Smiler's pause strat, as called out by Kilo.
All right. I'm going to put us back to our map set so you guys can just keep an eye on that while we wait.
Who called the pause, Chicken?
I don't know. All right, and we are back in. Let me switch this back over. Boom. Oh, dear. All right, looks like we're getting trolls here.
We are? Yeah, we see...
Tom Curran on the Kilo. Or on the sword.
On the Kilo.
Tom Curran on the Kilo.
And Jubby... Chubby's going to make some quick work of this, because they don't have a tank to block these shields, or block these rockets. I'm getting some halo progress.
Those are nice shots. Yeah, I really like Pharah on this point of this map. It's just a lot of free space if you know how to manage it.
Yeah, that was a miserable first attack from the side of Du Bois.
Yeah.
Come on, guys.
Absolutely.
Map diff matters. All right, they're going to swap to a real comp.
Yep.
They've got Tom Curran on the Pharah, Magical on the Doomfist.
Oh my god, what a shot! Jesus Christ. Kilo getting zoned out. Tom Curran getting res back up.
Let's Kilo see. Still on the Zen. Is fine, I guess, if they want to take Pharah duels.
Yeah.
Do you know if Discord and Power Boost is a one-shot on 200 health?
I don't think it is.
That's sad. It does make it significantly easier because you have more time to hit the second rocket. Okay. But Tom Curran's gonna die anyways. EMP will fall with him.
This is a barrage. Yep. This is a BM barrage more than anything.
And Magical will punch into the rockets and still die.
Yep.
Kilo staggered a little bit on point here.
I'll tell you what, this is classic Smilers. This is 100%
classic Smilers.
Win three maps, decide we control a little bit, and then get
yeah, decide we control a little bit because we're that good. Realize we're not that good. Get tilted by not being that good and lose.
I can hear Kilo in chat right now. Come on, guys, we gotta focus up. And then, oh, he didn't die.
He does swap off the Zen, which I'm sure has tilted him a little bit.
Yeah.
We're going to see the High Noon in the back line here from Vegetal. I don't see him getting anything with the sight line.
Yeah.
It's a nice zone, though.
Yeah, I know. I'm pretty good.
Nope, you're not.
Wow, all right.
Tom Curran still kind of losing this duel here. Taking a lot of damage, and Vegetal will pick him off. And we don't see Magical applying similar pressure to Jubby. Maybe because Jubby's got better angles, or Vegetal's kind of just too pressured in this back line. And the Far Duel is again going to be on top of this roof, and Jubby is
winning.
Jubby's making it work. Yeah. I never want to fight near a roof as Pharah. It's so easy to get the splash rocket hits.
Yeah. This is not pretty.
It is not pretty. A double kill coming out with that Sigma ult, and Master Dempsey is going to just retreat here.
Yeah.
And swallow some bullets as he dies.
Yeah, you know, and it really sucks to be a main tank in this meta when your DPS is getting shit on, because you can't do anything about it. Your DPS, this meta is just all about your DPS winning.
You stand there with your shield in one hand, dick in the other, like, well.
Yep.
You stand there remembering how good Goats was for guys.
Oh, God. All right. Curious to see if Tom Curran can get anything done with this barrage that he almost has. Misses.
And meanwhile, Chubby has built another barrage.
Holy unsurprising.
Vegetal holding on to the High Noon is going to make getting this pharmacy around in the open area hard. You see, as soon as they get around the corner, High Noon is popped, takes the Mercy. And the returning High Noon gets nothing from that.
Oh, Chubby is actually dead. And
Rez. Quick Rez coming out. Good death spot there from Jubby, landing on the high ground. And yeah, I'm seeing this as the last fight for the boys. They don't even make the second corner.
No, for sure not.
EMP will res up the main tank, and Tom Curran throws off barrage. Might be a clutch here. Yeah, good clutch coming out. Exotic on the Mercy. Yeah.
Yeah, that definitely looked like a barrage from Tom Curran being like, fuck you, you've gotten the best of me all game. They're all map. It's time for me to win this one, and I'll be dang.
So there could still be a last-ditch hold here coming out from Noweebs if they can get somebody there real fast.
And we'll see.
Yep, that's why this point sucks, because the defender spawn is so close. Jubby's going to get a pick, dies for it. I think they'll take that, though,
probably
because of the spawn
back,
advantage.
Though.
Yeah, okay.
Yep. Oh,
yeah, but meanwhile, while the Mercy was down, the Sigma will fall. And big Sigma ult lifting people off the point, but they still get some to contest. This fight is going back and forth, which, unless Du Bois can get some really big picks here, is going to be bad for them because of the spawn advantage. Alright. Master Dempsey just holding on for dear life. And Vegetal's going to point blank High Noon that far up.
There's the hold.
First point hold on Rialto, not unheard of. One of the worst first points of payload, in my opinion. So. Let's see if Noeebs can make this a respectable 1-3.
Yeah.
Get past first point.
Yep, absolutely.
And we saw there were some subs in. We have Exotic on the Mercy now. I don't know if that's because they're better at Mercy or because, you know, game's over already. Did you see anything in particular from Master Dempsey on the main tank? The Rhine fed hard, but that was, you know,
this was one throw. Yeah, they were just kind of fucking around.
I didn't see anything amazing coming out on the Orisa, but I'm not in tune to the, you know, how fast he can throw down shield ability or whatever it is.
Yeah. I didn't see anything particularly exceptional. Was definitely not, you know, using the combos ready with the Holt like we were seeing from Apple.
Yeah, that's true. And I think what I'm trying to get at is I think it'll be more critical here if they're going to run a real comp on defense, which looks like they want to. Where the main tank play is going to be a little more critical than it was on attack, where there's a lot of DPS dueling to try and get them around the corner, and the main tank has to, you know, bunker down and survive. Yeah. And so misplays on main tank on defense are a lot worse, I think.
Yeah. Yeah, you lose a fight on attack, that's fine. You just have another fight. You lose an attack on defense, you know, you're running out of space.
Yeah. They do have a lot more leeway, I think, on this point than some of the other ones. Like, you get it probably a solid 3 holds here if you're quick to come back. But we're going to see Vegetal actually on the Ash. I think expecting another Pharah duel, but they're going to be going up against Bastion Sim. And quick swap over to the Hanzo. This thing is good. They've got a lot of shield pressure coming out from their projectile DPS. I don't know if it's enough with the bullshit shield meta that's going on right now, but we'll see.
Tom Curran not having a good angle here at all to
heap. Yeah, they're just going to run right under him, and they kill him.
Yeah, they slurp him off the top.
Not a good start. Gila's going to fall as well to Jubby. Jubby hovering right over them, applying as much pressure as he possibly wants to. EMP will take him down while his teammates fall around. We're on our last ditch hold here. Tom Curran's going to have to punch in on this Doomfist pretty soon to get the stall. Tanks are coming in last, and they've actually swapped to a Reinhardt, I think, just so he can charge the point. And Tom Curran dies before hitting the ground. Jeez. Reinhardt charges in too, gets a nice immortality field from Kilo, and will survive. Got that going for them. But they got a hold here for 3 minutes.
Yeah, not looking pretty. A lot
good of window, I think, in the back line. Kilo's going to be able to heal his team up a butt ton and also get that bar out of his face. And immortality will not save Magical there, actually.
A good body block there from Master Dempsey, but it's not a dragon you can't body block.
It was a good zoning dragon. It caught people in damage and forced them to either side of the point.
Who's on point? EMP, of course it is.
Yeah, EMP disco dancing around that point. And a respectable last map win from No Weebs.
Absolutely. All right. There we go. And that's going to be play of the game. Rialto is a 1-0 in favor of No Weebs. We've done it, everybody. It's a 1-0. Okie dokes. Well, that was a great set of games. Sorry you guys had to miss the play of the game. Yeah, that's going to be it. I am not going to try to find us an interview. I do want to congratulate all of the players. Good job. You guys did great.
Very short match, actually.
Yeah, very short match.
Over an hour 10.
I think that we're all probably thankful for, so we can all go watch Overwatch League now. Right now, I believe it's the Seoul Dynasty playing the Hangzhou Spark, so that's exciting. That's going to be it for the Calzone cast today. I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, give me a follow. If you don't, whatever. Give us a follow anyways. Yep. This has been Calzone.live.
Give us a follow so you can know when to come back and roast us again.
Ooh.
And tell good old Zone to turn on health bars and fix the score.
That's true. I need that in my life. Okie dokes, everybody. That's going to be our stream. Thank you and good night.
We'll see you same time, same place, some other cast.